Lusitania was now ready for passenger service, but before she could do this, she had to undergo her sea trials to see if she was seaworthy. On board the Lusitania for her sea trials were not just her crew, but executives of the Cunard Line and the John Brown Shipbuilding Co. The British Admiralty wanted the ship to have a top speed of at least 24 knots. If Lusitania couldn't reach 24 knots, Cunard Line would be fined. So Lusitania was put to full ahead for the first time. Everyone held their breath as the speed increased. It went from 23 knots to 24, 25, and finally 26. Lusitania achieved a top speed of 26 knots, and with that, everyone celebrated. But then, something odd happened. The ship began to vibrate. It wasn't as bad towards the forward parts, but in the aft parts where all of second class was, it was so bad it made second class uninhabitable. The vibrations were caused by the wake being produced by the outer propellers interfering with the inner propellers. To fix this, they added support pillars in the second class spaces to help brace the ship a little bit. Of course, the vibrations persisted, but at least it wasn't so bad it made second class uninhabitable. Nevertheless, the Lusitania was seaworthy and ready to sail her maiden voyage. She would sail from Liverpool, England, to Cherbourg, France, to Cork, Ireland, and finally New York City in the United States. Her maiden voyage had her filled to capacity, even though she was 30 minutes late to gaining the blue ribbon. Thousands gathered to see her pull into New York. The return voyage to Liverpool saw her gain the blue ribbon for the eastbound crossing, and her next trip to New York saw her gain the blue ribbon for the westbound crossing. Lusitania was the largest and fastest ship in the world till the completion of her sister ship Mauritania in 1907, just 2 months after Lusitania was completed. The two ships fought over the blue ribbon till Mauritania gained it once and for all in 1909. Even though Lusitania was built for speed, she was also luxurious. James Miller was chosen to design Lusitania's interiors. He was a big fan of the Louis XVI style and used a lot of white oak, except for the veranda cafe on A deck, reserved for first class only. And speaking of first class, can we just take a moment to admire the beauty of this first class dining saloon? Obviously, first class was luxurious. Second class was comfortable with noticeable but mild vibrations. As for third class, I couldn't find much about their accommodations, but they were okay, but grew out of date with the Olympic class steerage accommodations. Speaking of Olympic class, even though Lusitania and Mauritania were luxurious, they weren't that luxurious compared to the Olympic class. The Olympic class had a pool, Turkish baths, squash racket court, a la carte restaurant, and slightly better cabins. Lusitania was faster than the Olympic class, and surprisingly more popular than the Mauritania. In 1909, New York was celebrating 70 years since the introduction of the paddle wheel steamer, at the event was to be the latest in technologies in transportation. Lusitania was there to represent the latest in steamship travel. The Wright brothers' plane was there, and Wilbur Wright flew it over the Lusitania and took some stunning photos of her. One night in January 1910, Lusitania was in a raging storm. Captain Turner left the bridge under the command of Chief Officer McNeil. Shortly after that, a huge rogue wave came out of nowhere and smashed into Lusitania's bow. The crew did what repairs they could at sea, and surprisingly, Lusitania was only delayed by a few hours with no casualties. In 1914, World War I broke out in Europe. Lusitania remained an ocean liner, while her sister Mauritania was requisitioned into an armed merchant cruiser. But the problem with converting ocean liners into merchant cruisers is 1. Their size, and 2. They needed thousands of tons of coal to operate. Mauritania was instead converted into a troopship. Sometime in 1914, the Lusitania's funnels were painted black to make it harder for enemy U-boats to fire at her. However, as we'll see later, this wasn't very effective, and on May 1st, 1915, the Lusitania departed New York for her final voyage.